Hello, my name is Renat, and in this video I'll try to shed some light on at least the most important of the many, many possibilities our Multi24 controller module has to offer. The Multi24 controller module can be used in various ways, of which I'll explain several in this video. It is 100% freely programmable, using structured text coding in the IEC 61131-3 Industrial Automation Programming Language, and it communicates using Modbus RTU over RS485 on two separate ports, and it has various extension possibilities. Let's dive right in and take a look at the Multi24 controller module. As you can see, the Multi24 can be ordered with mounting clamps for a DIN rail. This is for when the controller module is used inside a larger electrical cabinet or a box that also houses maybe a power supply, a fuse, an interrupter, or whatever else happens to be in there. When used, for instance, in a false ceiling or without any other technical equipment, order the Multi24 pre-mounted inside a plastic junction box. The PCB is then screwed straight into the box with IP55 class protection, and the cables can be pushed through the rubber wire hole covers. Let's look at the available connections. As its name suggests, the Multi24 controller module has 24 in and outputs, 12 configurable inputs, 4 relays, 4 0 to 10 volt outputs, and 4 TRIAC outputs, giving out a pulse width modulation signal. All in and outputs have 2 connection points, and wires can be very easily connected by simply pushing the cable into the spring cage connectors. To remove wires, press between the 2 connection points with a small screwdriver to release the spring cage and simply pull out the wire. Wires of maximum 1.5 square millimeters can be used for the inputs, the analog outputs, and the communication ports. The main power supply and the relays have larger connectors and can take wires up to 2.5 square millimeters. The module itself uses roughly 100 milliampere, and in addition, each activated relay about 30 milliampere. So a power supply of 500 milliampere is recommended. The 12 inputs are labeled M1 through to M12. The inputs can be programmed to measure resistance, voltage, or current. When resistance is measured, connect your sensor between a numbered connector and one of the ground connectors like this. To measure a 0 to 10 volts signal, simply connect the ground level of the sensor and the Multi24 controller module and connect the signal wire to one of the numbered connectors. Similarly, to measure a 4 to 20 milliampere signal, make sure the ground levels of the Multi24 controller module and the sensor are connected. And in addition to the signal wire, also connect a 137 ohms resistor to the numbered connector. The additional resistor should be placed between the numbered connector and the ground level. The module can be powered with 24 direct or alternating current. Connect the power supply to the P1 and G0 connectors and note that the TRIAC or pulse width modulation outputs, of course, only work when powering the Multi24 controller module with alternating current. The power supply is passed on through the 5 ampere fuse to the connectors marked P2 and G0. The 4 relays can each take a 6 ampere load at 230 volts and have common, normal open, and normally closed connectors. Each relay has an LED that lights up when the relay is activated. The connectors O1 through to O4 give out a 0 to 10 volts signal, as it is calculated in the programming. The connector sets V1 T1 through to V4 T4 send out the TRIAC or PWM output signals as calculated by the program. They can take a maximum load of 1 ampere, provided the power supply of the controller module is heavy enough. It is the T side of the connectors that is being switched, based on the output value that is programmed. That means that the V connectors thus always pass through the 24 volts from the power supply. For Modbus communication with the BMS, the MA and MB RS485 connectors can be used. The Modbus address can be set using the DIP switches. Note that they are marked 1 through to 6, but their value is binary and in the other direction. So the most significant dip, representing 32, is the one marked 1. The speed of the bus is automatically detected, and the two indication LEDs for receiving, RX, and sending data are located close to the connectors. Additionally, the Multi24 controller module has a secondary Modbus RTU channel on which it is master. Originally conceived to easily connect our multi-display, this RS485 port can be used to connect any and each serial Modbus device to the Multi24. Use connectors EA and EB to connect the communication bus. The aforementioned power connections P2 and G0 can be used at the same time to make cabling and wiring easier. Lastly, the MP connector can be used to communicate using the multi-point bus. This, however, requires an extension card.